From Sheriff's Headquarters in Monterey Park, this is LASD Update.
Hi, I'm Deputy Benjamin Grubb.
And I'm Sergeant Pauline Panis.
Welcome to LASD Update. The Los Angeles County Sheriff's Department's Scientific Services Bureau operates one of the largest full-service crime laboratories in the United States. A staff of nearly 300 members working from facilities all over Los Angeles County provides forensic science support to all Los Angeles County law enforcement agencies except the Los Angeles Police Department. I visited the largest and newest crime lab at the Hertzberg Davis Forensic Science Center, located on the campus of California State University, Los Angeles. Within this building, the Los Angeles Regional Crime Laboratory is occupied by both the crime labs of the Los Angeles County Sheriff's Department and the Los Angeles City Police Department. In addition, Cal State Los Angeles has facilities there to teach forensic science courses.
My name is Dean Giolamis, and I'm the Sheriff's Department Crime Lab Director. Our facility here, the Los Angeles County Sheriff's Department Scientific Services Bureau, is the county's main crime lab, if you will. We're located on a facility on the campus of Cal State Los Angeles. This is one of 10 facilities that we operate out of. Most of our work here at the crime lab deals with the recognition, collection, documentation, and analysis of physical evidence from crime scenes. Our job is to help investigators solve crimes by using science. And this facility here is our newest and largest flagship facility. It houses most of our major crime units, things like DNA and firearms, fingerprint testing, trace evidence, which is dealing with things like shoe prints, tire tracks, hairs, fibers, arson, explosives, as well as our chemical processing units and our photography and digital evidence studio. Our partners here in this building include the Los Angeles Police Department and their crime laboratory, the Cal State Los Angeles Criminalistics Program, as well as a component of the training facility from the California Department of Justice.
Criminalist Thompson showed us a few basic screening tools that are used in the lab.
These are examples of items that we would collect from actual crime scenes. We do our best at scenes to collect and preserve the evidence, but actually do the detailed analysis at the laboratory where we're in controlled conditions and everything can be sterile. These are examples of casts. So we had, in this example, we had shoe prints that were in dirt around a crime scene. So we created plaster casts of those shoe prints. And these are drying. And once they're completely dry, we'll wash the dirt off of it and you'll have a very nice impression of the bottom of that shoe. So this is a shoe impression in blood on a piece of tile. In an instance like this, this would actually be examined by our trace department and they would try to match it to different shoes and find unique characteristics in this pattern to be able to match that to the shoe that was used to make it. We're going to screen this for blood or test it for blood. We want to pick an area where there's not a lot of detail. So the test for blood, it's a three-step chemical test and all the chemicals are clear unless blood is present. You see how quickly and deeply that turned color. And once we get the DNA from the blood stain, we can compare it to a suspect reference sample or a victim's reference sample, or upload it into CODIS if it's related to the suspect.
Another tool utilized by the criminalist is an alternate light source, which helps reveal the presence of different types of fluid on a surface.
So if I was examining this item for the presence of semen, I would look at these areas that are fluorescing, I would mark them, and then I would use another chemical test to screen for acid phosphatase, which is an enzyme that's present in seminal fluid.
What would you say to someone that's interested in being a criminalist one day?
So my suggestion would be to get your degree in a chemistry or a biological chemistry and to find a way into a crime lab. Find a way to volunteer, get involved with a law enforcement agency, and find a way to become a part of this team. And that'll greatly increase your chances of being able to get into this field.
James Carroll, a supervisor in the firearms section of the crime lab, was able to explain the various resources and methods used for firearms and munitions identification and testing.
We're responsible for the analysis of any type of firearm or ammunition evidence. We do a variety of different things. We function test firearms. We compare evidence bullets and cartridge cases to suspected firearms. We perform certain types of gunshot residue testing, the restoration of serial numbers and obliterated markings. crime scene investigation for the documentation and recovery of firearms-related evidence, and really any other analysis involving firearm or ammunition type evidence. So we're in one of our test firing rooms, and this is a water recovery tank. It's a big stainless steel tank with about 600 gallons of water in it, and its purpose is to allow us to test fire firearms and slow the bullets down without damaging them. That way we can use those bullets for comparison at a later time. We're in our comparison microscope room, and this device we're looking at is a comparison microscope. It's essentially two microscopes that are linked together. It allows us to view two objects side by side under magnification. So we have a specimen here, a bullet on the left stage and another bullet on the right stage. And we can see on the screen just a very small portion of each of the bullets. There's a faint line down the center that divides one from the other. So we're actually looking at two different specimens. And we're looking at a series of what look like lines or scratches. Those are called striations. And those are caused by imperfections in the barrel of the firearm that fired the bullet. Different firearms will have their own unique set of imperfections in the barrel. So we're on our test firing range. This is just an indoor shooting range, and we use it when we need to test fire firearms for any number of reasons. If we need to determine whether or not a firearm is functioning properly, this is a place we can do it. If that was the type of analysis we were performing, and there's no need to recover a bullet, there's no need to use the water recovery tank that we took a look at earlier. So we can just test fire downrange here. Well, the type of gunshot residue testing we do here has to do with gunpowder patterns. When a shot is fired at a target at close range, a gunpowder pattern might be deposited on the target. So for example, if I were to shoot you at, say, a foot range, I would expect there to be a pattern on your clothing of gunpowder from that firearm. So in doing reconstruction type work, that might be a question. How far away was the shooter from the person who was shot?
We have over 300 sworn and civilian staff. The fine men and women who work here in this facility do a tremendous amount of work in a number of different areas.
These are just a few small examples of the kind of intense identification and testing that goes on at the crime lab. To learn more, please go to www.lasd.org.
Thank you for joining us on LASD Update.
Don't forget to check us out on Facebook, Twitter, Nixel, and Pinterest. Or, for more information, go to www.lasd.org.
Thank you for viewing LASD Update.